Malting and kilning is the start of turning barley into beer. Often at the end of malting and kilning, we have malt. So it's often referred to as the malt process. To start, we need to think about the barley. There are two main types of barley: two row, which is most often used in the brewing process, and six row. Two row has a smaller husk and is more uniform. Six row has a larger husk, is not as uniform, but has a slight advantage in enzymatic activity. In America, the six row is used often whenever we have an anjuic grain, such as rice or corn. The added advantage of the enzymatic activity of the six row helps whenever we're bringing in another grain component to help convert those starches. Two row is most often used whenever we're only using barley and not an adjunct grain. We take the grains from the barley, and what we want to do is start the germination process, just like you would planting a seed in the ground. You want to get it moist. And so therefore, what we do for the germination process is just steep the grain. We let it soak up water so that it'll start to germinate. When it starts to germinate, it'll start to form roots, and we'll see enzymatic activity that converts both our proteins and our starches. The main process that occurs right here is conversion of our proteins. We convert our proteins into smaller and smaller groups. Now, what is a protein? A protein is a long chain amino acid. So what's happening is we're breaking that protein, this long chain of amino acids, into smaller chains and into amino acids. We're also at this point activating some enzymes. There are several enzymes that are going to break down our carbohydrates. The main two are alpha amylase and beta amylase. There are some others that work at this time, but through the mashing process and the kilning process, they're going to be deactivated. It's the formulation of these two enzymes, alpha amylase and beta amylase, that are essential in this process. Once we have done the germination process, we need to stop the germination process by kilning. So what the kilning process does is bring the moisture level from 40 to 50% down to 3 to 8%. This arrests the germination process. It will maintain the enzymes, but because we are drying it out through heat, we will be destroying some of those enzymes. The two that are most important, the amylase, alpha and beta, will still have activity, but we will bring that down. The other possibility we have at this point with kilning is adding flavor. So if we raise our temperatures of the kilning process, we can add caramelization and even bitter flavors to the malt so that those can be brought out in our mashing process later. Now, if we go to a very high temperature kilning process, it will destroy our enzymes. So we have to balance these. If you use a very dark roast malt, meaning that we had a high temperature, most likely your enzyme activity is going to be lower. This lower enzyme activity means that you're probably not going to get as much of our maltose converted into fermentable sugars. So what you will see brewers do is mix pale malts with darker malts so that they can get the enzymatic activity of a pale malt, something that was kilned at a lower temperature, with the caramel flavors that come out in a Maillard reaction of the darker malts. Once we have gone through the germination process and the kilning process, we have malt. The malt, because of its low water content, is storable. Most often what you see in the U.S. is that people do not take grain and malt it themselves, but they buy the malt. Since it's only at 3 to 5% water content, that can store for a long time. And it's ready to turn to a mash. All we need to do is grind it, break open those husks so that we can get to the starches and proteins inside of the malt. So in the malting and kilning process, what we're going to be looking at is the activation of those enzymes so that we can get starch conversion into smaller sugars, and the Maillard reaction that occurs in the kilning process. We'll also be talking about what aspects brewers are looking for whenever they select different malts, based both on the flavor components, but also the enzymatic activity.